sound hitting different today, babe.
Yeah, it feels good though.
Yes.
Ooh. It's the golden time of day.
Yes.
I was taking a nap. My food from last night, those biscuits had me. Nah, I'm kidding, guys. How y'all doing? It's Friday. Oh, it ain't Friday. Boy, this week got me messed up. It's Saturday. We kept live. Hey, sweetheart.
Hello, sweetie.
You got me messed up, baby.
How?
I don't know. You looked at me and I got all messed up.
That's all I got to do is look.
All you got to do is look. Let's do some cooking. Hope everybody's doing good. We doing some pork, doing some pig today, and doing a little sweet potatoes, some asparagus. I kind of got the sauce already because of what I'm doing. I had to kind of go ahead and start getting that ready. But we're gonna do some stuff today.
Okay.
And have a little fun. That's cool.
Yes. Someone just said good night from Paris, Karima Bazid. Wow. Thank you for joining me.
Paris.
All right, now.
That's why I do grape juice.
Hello, Dory King, Sherry White, Susu Lindsay, Deanna Salisbury, Diamond a Dozen, Carol Dunn. This is going to be a good one, I can tell. What's up, Andrea Macy? Hey, sis, Sharon Brown is in the house. Carol Dunn, Karen Paul. Hey, Kip, what we cooking today?
We doing some pork tenderloin. And I'm going to make a little sauce with it. We're going to smear a little sauce with it. And I like sweet potatoes.
Is it blurry, guys?
It's blurry.
We're getting some bad weather.
And maybe it's all moving funny, huh? Matrix.
How is the vision? Y'all let us know. Hello, Gary Craig, Shirley Faye Williams, Annette Jones Baytop from Suffolk, Virginia, Martha
Suffolk.
Jones Scarborough.
Suffolk.
Suffolk.
Baby. Boy,
all right.
All them great, not great, all those new towns, boy.
Yes.
That's Suffolk, Virginia.
Okay. Not blurry. Okay. No, right. Okay.
So we can do some cooking?
We can do some cooking.
All right.
Let's get started.
Here's the pork tenderloin right here. There's a pork loin, and there's a pork tenderloin.
What's the difference?
The difference is you have the whole loin, this big piece of meat like that. And then you have this little tender piece, little strip on the side of it. It's like the filet. It's like the filet of the beef. So it's very tender cut of meat. Doesn't take long to cook. We're gonna start it on top of the stove, and then we're gonna finish it in the oven. Won't take long.
Gary Craig said you're getting closer to that pork belly.
Gary, man, I tell you what, brother.
He was going to cook it.
I talk about the pork belly and the way that I've done it so many times. So I got to recreate a new recipe, a way that I can do it quicker.
Yes.
I usually slow cook it. And I put it on the grill and I do some stuff. You know what? But you're a supporter, so I may do a special video.
Or he may wait till you come to town next month.
But anyway, we have pork tenderloin. I got some sweet potatoes. I kind of roasted them already. I was kind of sweating them so the peel would come off. They just came out of the oven.
We're going to mash them.
So I prefer to roast, even if I'm making a sweet potato pie, I prefer to roast potatoes versus
boiling.
And I'm going to tell you why. The reason why I do that is when you put, you cook something excessively in water, depending on what that product is, the water can sometimes can be so absorbed into the product that the
flavor
dilutes the flavor of the product.
Yes.
But when you roast it, the natural sugars of the potato kind of bloom.
Mm-hmm.
And I like the flavor. So I prefer to roast them, even if I'm mashing them, just for what I'm doing today, like a sweet mashed potato. Or if I'm doing a pie, I do the same thing. That's just my preference. You can do it the other way, but that's my preference.
If you do it the other way, I found, because that's what I grew up on, boiling them.
Yeah.
You just add more stuff to get the flavor back.
There you go.
You have to use more seasoning to compensate.
You're so right, baby.
Yes.
Then you can just work off the natural flavors of the product. I'll show you what we're going to do with it today. So I got some brown sugar that's going in.
Okay.
Into the mash. I got to pull out some seasonings for the
Yes. Hello, Shauna. She said pig. Hello, Carol Dunn, Gwen Bacon Jones. Mama's on. Mama coming. Mama may not know it, but she coming next week.
Mama stay ready, baby.
Thank you for the stars, Sharon Brown. Hello, Andrea Payton. Kimberly Mae Metz Brown, Karen Edmonds, Sue Bertestore, Jenny Matson. Thank y'all all for joining us. It's raining here. I know some parts are getting some tornadoes and high winds, so y'all stay safe.
Yes, please do that.
Hello, Evelyn Brown, Tracy Rucker, Gladys Cooper, Rita Murphy. Thank y'all so much.
Now I got my spices. I didn't pull the spices out for the potatoes.
Okay. So thank you for the stars, Daniel Randall.
So, in the sweet potatoes, I'm putting some cinnamon, some brown sugar, some ginger, some nutmeg, and we use some heavy whipping cream, too.
Okay.
So, we're going to whip those up. So, what we going to do first, baby? You know what? We're going to peel these potatoes.
Okay. My song gone. I'm trying to get the...
you. What song is that, baby?
You had that playing for me this morning.
Ooh, I woke you up with that this morning.
He got me out of bed and started swinging and swaying and turning and twisting.
I got her up out of bed and said, baby, I feel like dancing at 7 o'clock this morning. So, daydream.
Hey, Lola. Say hey.
Hello. She don't sound like a sweet person, does she?
She is.
Okay, so I'm going to take these... I just came a little closer to you, baby. I'm going to take these off. You know, I need something to put these peelers in.
Hello, Bridget Donaldson. Yvette Miner, thank you for the stars. Karen Edmonds, thank you. Hello, Elder R.T. Leek. Susu says she just baked 2 sweet potato pies. Yes.
All right.
They got hail and rain last night.
So I'm just going to pull these off. And I don't know if you noticed what I did. Some of you guys maybe do the same thing. I put the potatoes into... after I pulled them out of the oven, I put them into a bowl and I put plastic wrap on it, and it kind of makes the peeling just kind of naturally release itself.
Let's go somewhere. Thank you for the stars, Gary Craig. Fran Kitchen, we got sunshine now in Tifton.
Tifton, Georgia, huh?
Mm-hmm.
I'm assuming that's Tifton, Georgia.
Yes. Elder R.T. Leek, water does kind of kill the flavor. Yes, it does. Hello, Justine Guyton from Milwaukee. Thank you for the stars, Gina Harcum.
Okay. Peel this off right quick.
Mary Bell said, don't forget to fix her plate.
I got you, Mary. You got mom's name, so you know I got you.
Brandy Irvine is on.
What's up, brother? We talked this morning.
Yes. Spreading love through food. Happy Saturday. Sabrina says hi. Hello. We can't wait to see y'all.
All right, so I got the, that didn't take long.
Mm-mm.
So it comes right off real quick. Boom, boom.
They still hot.
Yeah, they're still hot. So we're gonna be going in the mixing bowl with those.
Okay. Sweet potatoes are so good for you. That's Brenda Coleman Harper. It was raining here in Atlanta earlier, but it's clear now. That's Gladys Cooper. Emma Ford, hello, evening. Thank you for the stars, Patricia Skipworth. We're doing pork tenderloin. He's gonna start it by pan searing it, and then it'll go in the oven. He's doing some sweet potato mash. I'm gonna come over.
I'm gonna mash the potatoes a little bit.
Okay.
Get that a little bit. You know what? Let me go into the bowl. This is gonna go right into the mixing bowl. Mash them a little bit.
Fran said, yes, it's Tifton, Georgia.
First.
Boy, a potato masher is so, so important in the kitchen.
Wonderful, too. So, what I'm going to do is, because I'm not ready to put all my stuff in it yet, to keep that heat in there, I'm just mashing them up. And I just cooked these potatoes about an hour.
In the oven?
Yeah, like 350. And of course, you can see they're pretty much mashed up. And I'm gonna put them in the mixer, and I'm gonna use my whip attachment.
Okay.
My whisk attachment. I call it a whip too.
Is it still freezing, guys? What's up, Jason Moore? Let's get this party started. Hello, Henrietta Johnson Morris. He'll start the meat in just a minute.
So we're gonna do that. And I'm gonna put some plastic wrap back over this. I should have kept that little piece of plastic wrap.
Mm-hmm. Thank you for the stars, Bethany Davis. Sharon Brown.
I'm just doing this so I can retain heat.
So how long is it gonna take the meat to get to where you want it?
15 minutes, huh?
All right.
Quick meals.
Yes, thank you for the stars, Annette Jones.
All right, so here's what we're gonna do. We're gonna go ahead and we're gonna tend to this meat right quick.
Okay.
I'm gonna put some more gloves on.
He's making pork tenderloin, sweet potato, mashed potatoes, and some
asparagus. Okay. So what I'm gonna do with the meat, the tenderloin has like a little silver skin on it. So I'm gonna trim some off. You know, I don't have to get every little piece off, but I'm gonna trim it down a little bit.
Hello, Troy Grant. Latrice Newhouse. The menu sounds great. Tasted asparagus for the first time last weekend on the grill. I tasted a nutty taste. Is that right?
Yeah, that's right. That is correct. So here's that little silver skin that I'm talking about. So we're going to take a little bit of that off.
And pork tenderloin is naturally lean, or did you shave fat?
It's naturally lean.
Okay.
Contrary to the belief, well, maybe some of you guys know this, pork actually is in most cases less fatty than beef. Mm-hmm. I mean, I know got somebody out there probably saying, what is Kip talking about? That's the truth, guys. It's more lean in a lot of cases, especially like this. So the temperature that I'm reaching for to cook this, me and Ty was talking about this earlier, is 145. 145 on pork? Yeah, you heard me right. We're going to be all right. You ain't killed me yet.
Thank you for the stars, Karen Devani.
USDA, the GBA, the FBI say that's all right. So.
Ain't no FBI.
Oh, FBI though?
No. Oh. Hello, Rolanda Fields, Sandra Foster. What kind of grape juice are you having?
What kind of grape juice I'm having? You know, I was undecided which one I wanted to have. When summertime comes, or it ain't summer yet, but when it warms up, I like dry wine, so if anybody's followed me and listened to me a lot, I love Sauvignon Blanc. It's a dry white wine. It's like Chardonnay without the oak, almost.
Mm-hmm.
So that's what I'm having today, a little Sauvignon Blanc.
Hello, Shawan Cooper.
A different one from last night, because that bottle from last night.
It got gone.
Ty drank it all. I don't know. What in the world?
I take that. Hello, Shawan Cooper. Marion Jackson. Asparagus is one of my favorite things to eat now. Yes, it is easily to digest. Hello, Gregory Cotton. Pearl Shelton. Hey, Rochelle Dudley.
Okay, so what we're going to do, if you notice, I got some plastic wrap on there. There's a reason why I have that on there. Because I'm going to use the cutting board for something else later. I didn't want to get anything on it. All right, so we get that out of the way.
Thank you for the stars, Latrice Newhouse. Oh, yeah, baby.
All right.
Like a fool, I went.
Okay, we're going to get the skillet on.
All right, it's time to cook.
So what am I seasoning up the pork with?
Berberay.
This is mine. I know if you look at the website, it says coming soon. Next week it'll be here. It'll be available for you. Berberay is a wonderful seasoning. Over 17 different spices I put together to put this wonderful spice together. Ethiopian inspired. In Ethiopia, berberay is like all-purpose seasoning.
Mm-hmm.
They use it on a lot of sauces, roast, I just love the flavor of it. And when it's being made, it like lights up the whole area.
Whole house.
The whole city.
Yes.
The whole state of Georgia is like, what is that smell? So
yes.
That's what I'm using today. Got my meat pretty much ready.
Thank you for the star, Sue Berta Store. Hey, Anita McCormick. Sharon Brown, can't wait for the new season to arrive. It's coming, sis.
Actually, Sharon Brown gets a sneak peek, don't she?
You get a sneak peek, sis.
She's got some on the way.
In your love package. For being a supporter. We sure do appreciate it.
All right, so we're going to... Oh, shoot. What am I thinking? I already had something ready.
Ooh,
in the
baby.
I had something.
Shawan Cooper says she loves our different recipes. Yeah, Kip, Kip. He goes,
call me Kip, Kip. You sound like my nephew. Kip, Kip.
Kip, Kip. Kip, Kip. He do call you Kip, Kip. Yeah. He goes outside of the box a lot, which is appreciated on my end, because we get tired of cooking the same old thing.
Yeah, we're going to season that up real good.
So does the Burberry include salt?
I can't even talk. Mm-hmm. It does. Mine have salt in. I probably do one without salt. And most Burberry spices are quite spicy. Mm-hmm. I kind of toned it down. Mm-hmm. So we eventually going to have like three versions. This version right here, which is the pretty moderate with salt.
Wow. Mm-hmm.
And then we're going to have one with no salt. And we're going to have like the original spicier version. This one actually has a little kick in it. You feel just a little bit of spice on the back of your tongue.
Mm-hmm. Is it for meat only, Sandra Foster?
I think... with cooking, like dressing, like putting on clothes. There's rules, but most rules can be broken. If you like something and you want to give it a shot, that's how recipes are created.
Mm-hmm.
You know, sometimes you get out of the box and you try something that's not the norm, and you find that, wow, that tasted good. I use it to make different sauces sometimes.
Yes. And he builds flavor with it. Bridget Ellis, yes, you are getting some. Dr. Kimberly Johnson, is that asparagus in water?
No, it's not.
No, it's not.
Okay, so I got that.
Shawan Cooper, we pinned the website in the description of this video, but I'm going to pin it again now.
Okay. All right, so that's seasoned up.
Hello, Vanessa Thomas. Hello, Martha Harvey Lewis. Yes.
Now, in this spice, there is not a... I don't have a lot of salt in it.
Okay, yeah. Elder R.T. Leek was asking.
Yeah, it's just a little. So usually what I do, I sprinkle just a little bit more kosher salt on that. Let me add a little oil to this. And I'm going to rub it down. Use every glove in the house.
Thank you. We get some oil. Thank you for the stars, Barbara Simmons. So that's just olive oil.
That's olive oil.
You've seasoned it. Added just a little bit more salt.
A little bit of kosher salt.
Because salt helps build crust when you're pan searing.
That's it, baby.
I learned a little bit.
So much. You didn't learn how to do some of this stuff.
I learned.
I'm not saying you don't know how to cook, but you learned something about it.
Get that in there. Get that disclaimer in there. Hello, Brandy Burton, a.k.a. Taco.
My good friend.
Your boss was mad at the crawfish you sent him.
Yeah, Brandon, don't be sending me pictures. Don't be posting pictures of crawfish if I can't get them, man.
Thank you for the All stars, right. Martha Harvey Lewis.
So I just kind of massage that into the meat.
What you do, baby?
Massage that into the meat.
Ain't no wrong with touching your food.
All right.
Some people are funny about that. Just put some gloves on. You got to show it some love.
All right, so now we're going to get the... I guess I should bring me a little trash can over here.
Hello, Tanya Wobwire.
I'm going to put some grapeseed oil actually into the skillet too. So I'm mixing up oils right now because I'm going to get the skillet kind of hot.
Tanya Wobwire, taco laughing about your crawfish.
All right, so we're good.
Hello, Howard McNeil. We play the Dusty. You talking about the music, I'm thinking.
Playing what?
Dusties, oldies, but goodies.
Yeah, man. That's how I roll, brother. Yeah, I like some new stuff, too. But I'm old school to my heart.
Latrice Newhouse said she likes the fact that you season all over. Some chefs sprinkle a little salt and pepper on one side. Hello, Deborah Banks Anderson.
I want to know we got what it's going to that it's gonna taste right. Think it's hot enough, baby?
I hear that. Oh. Babe, why you playing? Gary Craig said this is gonna be good.
All right, we got that in there. That probably should have been hotter.
Yeah.
Yeah. It should have been hotter.
But it's got a sizzle. Jason Moore, I saw him on earlier. I forgot to say what's up, brother.
Okay.
Your brother
right, so
from
we,
another
we got,
mother.
We got it working. And already, I know you're not here.
But you can smell
but already,
it.
Already, like the aroma is like kicking, y'all.
Yeah.
I'm telling you, it's kicking.
And these are pork tenderloins, if you're just joining.
Okay, so while we got that going, I'm going to put some heavy whipping cream into a pot. And this is going to be for the sweet mashed potatoes.
Hello?
We're going to start with about a half a cup.
Yeah, you can do something different to your mashed potatoes. I'm excited about y'all taking a look. Chandra Halliburton from Detroit.
I'm
hello.
Put about four tablespoons of butter in there. I like butter.
We're gonna put
six tablespoons of butter.
Oh Lord. Heavy whipping cream and butter. And this is something he's mixing up for the sweet mashed
just
potatoes.
Just a sprinkle of salt.
Hello, Pamela Hargrove. Thank you for watching.
Some brown sugar. About a half cup.
So heavy whipping cream, butter, brown sugar.
Yeah. Some ginger. About half a teaspoon. Some cinnamon. About a half teaspoon.
Hello, Jenny Maston. She said it looks great. I know the aroma in the kitchen is kicking.
Nutmeg. We're going to do the same thing. So I had equal measurements. I think I just got this nutmeg. But I need to take a little later.
Latrice said the pork scratching like on record player.
You know about that.
Yeah, Sharon Brown said, I know it's smelling good. Go ahead, Kip. Thank you for the stars, Buso Dean.
Okay, so we got cinnamon, nutmeg. Did I put the brown sugar in there?
Yes, brown sugar is in.
Ginger. And let's see how this pork is doing.
Okay.
Doing good.
You waiting on the release?
It's release, baby.
It sure is.
All right, so I'm gonna crust it up on all sides.
Okay. You see that amazing color that Burberry gives? Look at that crust.
Okay, so we got that going. This is, on the back burner, is my mixture that's going into sweet potatoes.
The mashed sweet potatoes. Levonzel Stewart, same thing I'm making tonight.
Really?
Yes. Hello, Willie Kirkland.
You got a good meal plan
there. Idia Amos. Hello, Cheryl Davis.
I need to wash my knife right quick.
Linda Tyler Deshaun. Glad to catch you live.
You have a different knife for that.
Yes, Wind Down Wednesday is funny. Thank you for the stars, Rhonda Remo. We're doing pork tenderloin, sweet mashed potatoes, and pan-seared asparagus. Thank you for the stars, Linda Tyler Deshaun.
Hey, while you guys are watching, if you don't mind, hit your share button. So, you know, somebody else might want to know about us. But hit the like and share button. And a few people saying they don't get a notification. There should be like a little black bell in the right-hand corner. If you hit that, it will always pop up when we're live.
That's right. Okay. Is that KJ Kwu?
Yeah.
KG Kwu.
Yeah.
That's what it is.
Some of our comments earlier.
Yes, I'm just joining. What's on the menu? Thank you for joining.
All right. So we got the pork tenderloin cooking on all sides. We have KJ. I'm probably
KG.
We got pork tenderloin, sweet mashed potatoes, and we're going to saute some asparagus.
Okay.
So while that's doing, it's
y'all should see Lola over
back dancing.
I thought
she wasn't feeling good earlier.
But I nursed her back to health. Leave my babe alone, yes.
Okay, so we're just going to warm this up.
You can tell when they start feeling better, though. Gyrating through the house.
We're going to warm this up a little bit. And the reason why I warm up my cream and the butters and all that, so that my temperature doesn't go down on the potatoes when they go into it. And it helps with getting it good and creamy.
Hello, Shirley Turner. KG Kwu.
Okay.
That's what it is.
Okay, so now it's cooking. So I've turned it down just a little bit. Now that I got a sear. And we're going to go in the oven in just a minute. And we're going to finish it up in the oven.
So
I hope you guys like music as much as I do. That's why we just have that. you know, always since I've been an adult. Now, when I was at mom's house, when I was growing up, I could have the music playing, but I could only drink that grape juice that she bought at the grocery store in the plastic container. But when she let me go, I remember my dad saying, "Mom never liked this." He'd tell his son, "Boy, do whatever you're big enough to do." Mom said, "Don't tell them that."
That could be a disaster.
But I had the greatest parents in the world. Definitely my mom is wonderful. Okay, so pork is doing right. I'm ready to get this in the oven and get it out of my face.
How many children do you all have? Just the one.
Just one. One and done.
KG says, "Sounds delicious. Give me your address and we're on the way." Did Lola tear the shrimp up last night? Yes, she did. She had shrimp and salad.
Okay, so we get ready to go in the oven, baby.
Thank you, Linda Hutzel. She said, "Such a great job of explaining things." The searing process, I wanted you to touch on that a little bit. The searing process is to do what? You want the crust and then to secure the moisture.
And secure the moisture and flavor. Searing it gives it such a great, great flavor. It adds to the action of the product itself. So I enjoy that.
Hello, Kissy Maurice. Thank you for joining.
So what I have right here, it looks like Jell-O, right? I know, it does.
It tastes a little bit like Jell-O.
What I did earlier today, well, a couple hours ago, I took some orange juice, some pomegranate juice, and some rosemary, some garlic, and a little bit of salt. And I cooked that, I boiled it up a little bit. And then I actually kind of put some gelatin in it to kind of gel it up. And then I'm going to do a couple things.
It tastes good, guys. It's a little sweet, savory concoction.
And kind of...
Thank you for the stars, KG.
And this is going to be like, really not a sauce. It's going to be like a smear on the plate. But you can take like vegetables and fruits to create what I'm doing right now. I know it looks a little thick right now, but we're going to loosen it up. And I'm going to whip it up a little bit in a minute.
Thank you for the stars, Kissy.
All right. Put that over there, sorry.
So when you smear a plate, baby, that's more than just for the look of it.
More than look. You want more than looks. You want taste too.
Hello, Shirley Madison.
So I'm just gonna whip it up and then I'm gonna hold it off for a minute till I'm ready to plate. So
it smells delicious. I smell the rosemary.
Smell it?
Yes. Yeah. Pomegranate rosemary. That's okay, Shirley Madison. Linda Tyler Deshong, does chef cook Caribbean food like the brown stew chicken? Ooh, yes, he does.
Yes.
He loves curry goats.
We are lovers of the Caribbean. Jamaica, to be exact.
We
vacationed there several times and... one of our favorite places to hang out. So now that I got the
meat in the oven.
The meat in the oven. I'm gonna put my attachment onto the mixer. Get in there, girl.
Everything is a girl in the kitchen. I ain't mad at you, baby. Okay. Talk to her.
We're gonna turn it off.
Okay. And these are the mashed potatoes. He baked, roasted them in the oven. He roasted them in the oven. All right. Okay.
We're gonna whip it up a little bit.
So he's adding the warmed up cream, brown sugar, and spices into the sweet potatoes. A little bit at a time.
All right.
Hello, Tamika Mentor.
So I'm gonna cream it up and get them smooth and rustic at the same time.
Sweet mashed potatoes. Hello, Willie Mayhow.
I'm gonna give it a taste to see how we're doing. See what I need to adjust.
Wow.
Put a little bit more in there.
And so he warmed up the cream, guys, to keep the temperatures. The potatoes were
and
hot.
It helps with getting the consistency that I want as well.
Okay. Fran said, looks like pie filling. We need a crust. I think we need a crust. It looks like pie filling. Hello, Constance Blanchard.
So we're going to add a little bit more nutmeg to it. How about that?
Okay. And whipping the sweet mashed potatoes and getting the air in it, you get a
makes
great
it light
whip.
And fluffy.
Yes, because you want whipped.
A little bit more cinnamon. Just a pinch more of salt.
Okay.
Sam, scrape down the bowl a little bit.
Willa Mae says she'll be over when you finish. Open the door. We sure will.
So what I'm going to do right now, I'm going to pull the attachment out, get some of these strings off.
Thank you for the star, Suzette Laws.
Get some of those strings off, and we'll be right back.
All right, y'all, I'm trying to let y'all see these whipped up mashed potatoes. Was the milk mixture sweet condensed milk or whole milk cinnamon?
It was heavy whipping cream.
It was actually heavy whipping cream.
You know, sweet condensed milk would have been great too. I can't, you know what? I can't push back on that one. But the potatoes are pretty good. They have a good sweetness about them.
Everybody's saying, what a crust. That's not fair. I don't have a mixer. Joyce Smith, you can use a hand mixer.
A hand mixer.
Yeah.
You can use a whisk if you like.
A whisk, yes.
You know? Just using this because I have it and it doesn't take as long.
We ain't always had no mix it.
What happened to life?
What's up, cousin Ronnie Carter? We're doing pork tenderloin. Sweet mashed potato.
Okay.
Hello, Kimberly Brown.
So while that's going, I'm going to check on the meat.
Gary Craig said it's Sunday dinner. Thank you for the stars, cousin Ronnie Carter. So he seared them on top and put them in the oven.
And they're about ready.
They're about ready.
Yeah.
Looks and smells delicious.
So since I am going to add a little bit. I'm okay. I'm going to grab a little bit more butter in a second.
Okay.
They're not quite there.
I love the color, and that's the Berberet seasoning.
All right, so you go no more.
Change your mind.
I scrape the bowl down. I don't know, I grabbed a little small spatula, baby.
It's okay.
One more whip, and that's it's done.
The seasoning for the pork tenderloin, it's his own personal mixture that will be available for sale next week. It's called Berberet. Fran, thank you, Sandra Foster. Kimberly Brown, don't let the green grass fool you. My kind of music.
Now that song that's playing right now, Kimberly,
that was
happened to be like probably my dad's favorite song of all time. He would come home on Friday nights from work. He put that 45 on, and we danced off of that by like 5 times. I mean, and it stays in my head. It's one of the best things to do.
Uh-oh, it's freezing up.
All
right. Okay. I pinned the site. It's cookingwithkip.square.site.
We're going to put a little bit more of that in there. This is here. You won't hurt it. Put it all in there.
Put it all in there.
Nobody ain't making too soupy. Nah, it's good.
Good consistency.
Yeah, it's going to be all right. Yeah. I'm like, what am I going to do with this later on?
These are our sweet mashed potatoes.
Yeah, we good.
We good?
Yep, we good.
Ronnie right. Carter says, looks tender the way they flopping around when you handle them. That's right.
So, I'm gonna wash these off right quick.
Okay. Hello, John Douglas Jr. Hello, Kip and Ty. How are y'all this evening? What is Kip cooking? Pork tenderloin. Yes, he is. Yes, he is. There's a difference between the pork. What's the other cut?
It's just called tenderloin.
A tenderloin. And then what was the other cut? I think we had one in the freezer.
No, I'm sorry. One is called a loin.
One is called a loin.
And the other one is tenderloin.
And the other is a tenderloin.
Yes. And they come from the same area. The tenderloin is right on the at the edge of the cut of that one.
Yes, Shirley Turner. I get the alerts from Panama City, and I kept getting the alerts. It was nasty in your neck of the woods this morning.
All right.
Hello, Yolanda Cunningham, Barbara Bunny Jones.
All right, so I'm just cutting off. Usually, you know what? The rule of thumb with these are you cut them at the bend, because mm-hmm. that part is going to be tough. So it's bending right there. So that's why I'm cutting that part off.
I never knew that, baby. I just cut it up.
Yeah. You find the bend. So wherever the average bend is, I just cut the rest of them that way. I'm not going to cut and bend all of them. Okay. So there we go.
Kimberly Brown, we got you. I'm soon as this live is over, I'm going to send you our address. She's been trying to send us the wine,
baby.
Okay.
All right. Yes. We'll get it to her. All right. So that, we're going to put a little olive oil into the skillet.
Everybody said they didn't know that either about the bend.
Oh,
I just be cutting it up, okay. Making it pretty. I said, I'm up enough. Ain't know nothing about no bend, but you learn something new every day. Barbara Bunny Jones, love the shirt, Kip. Thank you.
Okay, thank you so much.
We have them in black and gold.
Okay, so we're going to put a little bit of this, some more butter on there. Yeah, because butter goes on everything.
Butter makes it all better.
Yeah, it's like bacon. Butter's like bacon. You put it on there, it's gonna make it right. Okay. I'm gonna put a little bit of garlic in there.
Hello.
Granulated garlic right today.
Emily Thomas. So granulated garlic powder and butter. And you put oil as well, right?
Yes, a little olive oil. And then I'll put a little pepper on it.
Sharon Brown said, butter, baby, butter.
Butter, baby.
Dora King, I knew about the bean. Kip showed us this a while ago. Uh-oh, yeah. I wasn't paying attention. Where was I?
Baby, that must have been the night we were drinking them hurricanes.
Don't everybody mention them hurricanes. Hello, Fabnisa Euless. Thank you for joining.
Okay, so that's hot. We're going to add some asparagus to that thing.
Okay. And I like a crunch to my asparagus.
Yeah, I don't like to cook them to death.
Yes, Barbara Bunny Jones. I'm a pin it again. Thank you for the stars.
Used a bigger skillet. You were right.
I was right. Say that one more time.
You was right, baby. I should have used a bigger skillet for the.
Is it too late to switch it?
Nah, we're going to roll with this thing. I'll make it work. I had another big set of time.
Right here?
And
yeah. Thank you for the stars.
All right, so I got some heat going on the.
Gary Craig, we're going to get you to try these asparagus.
He don't do asparagus?
No, he said maybe I'll try them this way.
All right, so what you all want to do with asparagus is overcook. Clean up over here. I'm going to throw these away.
We might have to do him some bacon wrapped, prosciutto wrapped asparagus.
Yeah, you might like them, but that's kind of more on the raw side.
That pork show do smell good. Is it ready to come out, babe?
Yes, it should be ready.
You want that other towel?
Yeah. It's ready. Just pulling a little bit of that over my meat.
Thank you, Dora King. Gary Chris said, okay. He's not convinced.
Get some of that flavor out of the bottom of there.
Mm. Do you ever cook the asparagus in the oven?
Yes, I do.
That was Kimberly
Brown. Kind of the same way. I mean, I don't overcook them. Just kind of get them right. Now we're going to let that just kind of sit there for a minute.
Because we're going to slice them up.
Slice them up.
Angela Watkins Frazier, I'm new to cooking with Kip. You both are awesome. It's like spending time with family, and that's exactly what we want. Thank you so much for joining us.
So we're getting some of that flavor into the asparagus. When they get a bright green, which they're starting to get there.
Lola is in the house.
Did she show it up?
Yes. Elder RT Leak, I didn't know about the bean. Just wrapped them in bacon and put seasonings on it and baked them. Me too. Well, I do cut the ends because I know the ends can get hard. Pork tenderloins, crispy and beautiful color. Looks good. I got a woman. Well, the time. Don't start none, won't be none.
All right. Erica's about to be there,
man. They said, hey, Lola.
Lola ran off. You mentioned her name.
You slide in this kitchen one more time.
What's she stealing?
I don't know.
39? Oh. Okay. Got it. All right. So you see that the color is brightening up.
Yes.
And if you cook them too long, they go from bright to dim. They start to look a little dull looking. I want them to have that bright color. And that little stuff that's right in the bottom of the skillet, if you notice, I'm just kind of scraping that up.
And tossing. Yeah, hello, LaTanya Washington Harris. Colette Sand Skipper.
And I'm going to pull a little bit out of the pan with a what?
That's that grape juice, y'all.
Grape juice. All right, then I'm going to pull them out of there. I'm going to add a little bit more butter. Create like a little sauce.
Sharon Brown, y'all better leave Lola alone.
All right, there we go. Create a little sauce with it. Oh, yeah, that's it. That's it. Okay. All right.
Yeah, you had a little passion in that. That's it right there. You, I know. If that girl run through here one more time, sliding with them socks on.
All right, so we about there. Dora, we're gonna start plating, baby.
Dora King says, I always overcook my asparagus. Lola is soon to be 15. Pray for us. She'll be 15 in July.
Grab a couple plates.
Okay. Yes, he did. And that was just, babe, why you add that wine to the asparagus?
A little bit of flavor, and I wanted to create like a little bit of a sauce with it. With the butter and the wine, it's gonna, if you notice, it's got a, wait a minute, let's see. It's got a little bit of that right there.
So it was garlic already in the bottom
garlic
of the
was
pan
already in there,
so with the salt, and you just added the wine for
that's
added
it.
Flavor.
That's it.
Yes, she'll be 15 in July. Thank you, friend. You all have a good evening as well. Thank you for joining us.
All right, so we're going to just cut. Yep. I don't know. I guess I was going to put the plates right there.
Yeah.
Come over this one. We're
going to leave her alone. When she slide and break something, Sharon, you're going to have to come take her to the doctor.
All right, so we're going to plate over there. I'm going to cut the meat over here.
Okay. Thank you, Kimberly. Please pray. Willamette said she's tried asparagus, but they had strings.
I'm not sure what.
Was it the asparagus or the sweet potatoes? Yes, Brenda Coleman Harper. He know he did something.
He did what?
Lola is July 21st and mine is July 20th. Kip got double trouble. They
all
after
right,
each
so
other.
I'm finishing up this. I took my whip. Kind of whip it around a little bit.
This is the pomegranate, rosemary,
and orange.
And orange, blood orange sauce. Hello, Dolores Rosser. Lola.
It didn't spread out the way I wanted. Let's do that
you want
again.
Your brush?
So help I put the pork on top of that.
And this is a blood orange, pomegranate, rosemary gelatin that he made. That's going to be a good complement to the pork. Willamette said she may have cooked them too long. Is the frozen asparagus good too?
I've never had frozen. I'm going to be honest with you. So I couldn't answer that correctly. But I would prefer the fresh because you have a little bit more control. The frozen has probably been blanched a little bit, so it doesn't take probably long to overcook those.
They Miss Dora King said, you're so blessed to have us as parents.
Okay, so we're gonna put some asparagus on here.
Turn that on another song. Is it behind me? That was a Sauvignon Blanc, so it was like a dry white wine.
That's correct. So we're gonna cut some pork now.
Leave it there. Sandra says she'll stick to the fresh. Lola's birthday is the same day as my husband's, the 21st.
It's not right here.
I can't wait to cut a piece.
They slide right back in front.
Okay. So he's going to put the mashed potatoes down. Yes, Marie Price. Lola, come say hi. She'd be funny about this camera, honey. We'll see.
Okay. Huh? What'd you say?
Come say hello. They want to see you.
Hello.
No, come here. No, these people haven't.
I'm going to leave that little bit of mashed potatoes right there. All right, so let's do this. Go ahead and cut up some meat.
Those are not coming. Now leave her alone. That's your auntie Sharon Brown.
All right. So we're going to cut this right quick.
I'm just going to put your Miss Shauna said, hey.
Hello.
She ain't coming on camera, y'all. Gary Craig said, help me, Lord. All I'm thinking about is crust. Hi, Lola. That's Sandra Foster about these sweet potatoes. Yes. Sharon Brown said, you don't have to come on camera. You one of them aunties, huh, Sharon?
All right, so we're going to put that on here.
Food looks delicious. I need to be you guys' friend.
See what it tastes like.
Sheila Walker.
Mm. Want to taste it, baby?
Mm-hmm. Yes, ma'am. You better believe. Ooh, that's good. Mm. Oh, that Bubba Ray. Babe, that sauce in that pan will make a great little gravy.
I'm going to put something on there. I probably could have stirred a little something into it.
Great presentation. Yes, it's sweet potato mash, Barbara Bunny Jones.
I got that one over there with like 4 pieces on it.
I see.
Baby, I bump you and I spill the stuff on the plate.
It's okay. That's that pan sauce he pouring over.
Okay, let's clean that up.
That pork loin looks right. I can smell it all the way in Dallas, Texas. That's Latrice. Cousin Ronnie said, looking good, cuz. Thank you, Dorothy Lockbridge. Food Network Perfect. That's Gary Craig.
All right, we're going to add a little bit of microgreens. I had some spill from last night. So, you know, they don't last forever.
I want to taste some potatoes. A lovely day.
We're
going
to put a little bit of the microgreens on there.
Thank you, Willa Mae Howe. Oh, my, that looks delicious. Don't you hear me ring the doorbell? Open the door, Ty. You coming to save Lola?
All right. I like eating these little greens. They're good, y'all.
They are. They pack a powerful punch. Yes, Kimberly Brown said.
Some pomegranate seeds.
Are you a professional chef, baby?
Me?
Yes.
No, I'm just your husband, baby.
No, actually, oh, you're mute. She asked, was you a professional?
Oh, okay. Actually, I'm self-taught. And I've been doing it for a long time. For years, I just ran the restaurant, didn't do any cooking. And now I get a chance to explore and experiment a little bit more.
Yes, he cleans as he cooks. Brenda Coleman Harper says $100 plate right there. Presentation is everything.
There you go.
Babe, you gonna take some pictures?
Oh, where's yours?
Oh, that's a good question. I love you.
We'll save one, babe.
Okay.
All right, yes. So I'll taste one and see what we got. That's mine over there.
With the four pieces on it.
Let's see what it tastes like.
Thank you for the stars, Elizabeth Gillian.
Potatoes.
You put some of them in my mouth.
Oh, you
want
to taste it?
Yes, boo.
I'm up here, babe.
All we need is a crust. Prince Jeter, hello, all late, but I'm here. We will take a picture of it, Tobiah Browder.
The sauce?
Them sweet potatoes. It's everything.
I like to just take it and just get all that on there.
Stopping. I love you.
Now I gotta taste the asparagus. I lost my grape juice.
I love you, cause you're you.
All right, so then I'll taste a little bit of the asparagus.
Dolores Ross of the Food looks great. I had baby racks with honey, barbecue, garlic, mashed potatoes, and steamed broccoli from Applebee's. I'm full as a tick.
Guys?
Yes, we will, Kimberly Brown.
That's pretty good.
It is pretty good, babe. I can't wait to dig on it.
Tenderloin, sweet mashed potatoes, a little reduction of the pomegranate and orange, and the sweet mash. I'm naming stuff over and over now, but my mind is messed up behind this food. But it's good, guys. And I've enjoyed hanging out with you on this wonderful Saturday. It's starting to rain outside, so we're just going to eat some more food. You know, have a little grape juice, reflect on this week.
Yes.
Tomorrow's Sunday. And it's been a joyous week. Go ahead and smile. We all have a reason. You know why? Because we have people and friends and family in our lives. We get to hang out. And if nothing else, our goal is to spend time with you, share food, share thoughts, have some conversation.
And share love.
And continue to grow. Share some love. That's what it's all about. So if you get a chance, share the post today. Like it. And continue to do what you do. And we'll do the same. It's been a plum pleasing pleasure.
As well as a privilege.
We're going to get out of here. And I'm going to enjoy some of this. And you enjoy your evening. See you the next time. Hopefully we'll see you Wednesday. Wind down Wednesday. It's always
a trip.
We don't know where it's going. So y'all have a good one. Love you. Mama next week.
Okay? Mama's coming. Y'all spread the word.
If I have to grab a Wednesday and bring her, and she have some grape juice with me, Spy, that's what I'll do. Y'all have a good night.
Yeah.
Babe, I'm going to eat some more food.
Sweet love.